We are free in Him. And I think one of the greatest battles that we face as a Christian is to remember that we are no longer slaves to what? Slaves to sin. Sin has no power over us. That's why Galatians 5:1, Paul says, therefore, stand in the liberty by which Christ has made us free. We need to stand in that liberty. But you might say, and I say, but God, how do we do that? We face the same temptations over and over again. We look at the world and the same things bombard us. How do we do it? Do you want to know the secret? It's found in Galatians 2:20. You can look it up when you go home. Do you want to hear it? Galatians 2:20 says this, I have been crucified in Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. Recognizing that it is no longer me or I that live, but Jesus lives in me. And the life that we live right now in this body, the body that faces the same temptations, we can know that we live by what? Faith, not works. We live by faith in the Son of God who loved us and gave himself for us. When that truth goes from here, from our heads to our hearts, I'm telling you, we can live free in the liberty. So let's sing about that freedom right now as we worship the Lord.
You can't set the captives free. You can't. Draw
I love the beginning words. I love the beginning words of this song. God, I look to you. God, I look to you. I think that's the key to life, isn't it? Some of you in this place, you're going through a very fruitful season. That's wonderful. That's God's blessing. But God is saying, keep your eyes on me. Some of you are going through a very dry season. God is saying, keep your eyes on me. And I wonder in this place, some people are going through a very difficult, heart-wrenching season. God is saying, keep your eyes on me. And I just wonder, there's someone in this place right now that is thinking this, but God, what about that person? They trusted in you and it didn't turn out so good. I'm here to tell you, God wants me to tell you right now, keep your eyes on me. That is none of your business. You keep your eyes on me. And the words that we sang are found in Psalm 121. Listen to God's words. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm, not some, all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. That is his promise to you. It doesn't matter what happened to so-and-so. God's promise to you never, ever fails. Amen. Let's respond with prayer. God, when we hear such amazing, precious promises, all we can say is like Mary, Lord, be it done to me as you said. And that's our response today. And with that, we just say, Jesus, we worship you. We love you. We exalt and magnify your name in this place right now. To you be all the glory forever and ever. Amen and amen. It is so good to be worshiping the Lord with all of you in this service. Let's go ahead and stand to our feet as we get ready to worship the Lord together. And if you are tuning in via live stream tonight, welcome. I'm so glad you're part of our service. And I'm confident that God's presence is with you even right now. And you know, we're going to be participating in the Lord's Supper tonight. So I encourage you, get some bread, get some juice, and join us as we take part of the Lord's Supper later on in the service. And with that, I do want to let you know that we are kicking off a new theme this month called Love Is. And you'll notice that everything about this service, from beginning to end, from our worship song to the message to the conclusion, it's all going to be about God's love for you and for me. Isn't that cool? And you know, the songs that we're going to sing tonight is going to declare that there is only one God. It's going to say that in Him there is only one Savior, and that we stand in His grace. And when we do so, no matter what it is in life you're walking through, you will dance again, my friend. You can rejoice in the fact that you will dance again because of God's amazing love for you and me. So open your hearts wide. Let's worship Him with all we have because of His amazing love for you and me.
Breaking through this moment, worthy, worthy is the broken generation. When all is dark, you help us see.
Seen your glory fall.
our King is coming back again.
Your love for us. And God, we're so grateful that we can know that love and that we can rely on that amazing love. But God, we also want to pray tonight, according to your word, that we would come to know the love of Christ that is beyond knowledge, that we would know the width and length and depth and height, to know your love in a greater measure, in ways that we have not known up to this point. So God, we open our hearts wide tonight as we get ready to receive your precious word. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your Holy Spirit who is here right now doing his work in each one of us. We love you, Jesus, because you first loved us. We worship you. We praise your name, Jesus, in this place. Amen and amen. Wow. It is so good to worship the Lord with all of you tonight.
Why don't you go ahead and stand to your feet. We'll begin our service right away. How many of you guys had a great day today? Yeah, it's only going to get better. We're about to worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. And we're just so thankful to be in the house. I'm going to read a scripture to you before we get started. And it says this in Isaiah 43. It says, "Now this is what the Lord says. He created you. He formed you. He says, don't be afraid because I have saved you. I've called you by name. And you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you cross rivers, you will not drown. When you walk through fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not hurt you. This is because I, the Lord, am your God." Tonight, we want to lift up his name. We want to worship him with all of our might. He's worthy of our praise. Tonight is going to be an amazing night. And the word says, where two or more gathered, there he is in the midst of his presence, and he's here right now. So let's give him all of our heart. Whatever you're facing, whatever you're going through, let's lay it at his feet.
Come on, let's all put our hands together. Sing of his love.
Your love breaks on me like an ocean,
and I'm caught up in your rolling seas, and your love is a place like a wide open space. Call me out into all I can be. I found that life in the city. I found your kingdom on my knees. I found salvation wild and free. When I found you, I found that life in the city. I found your kingdom on my knees. I found salvation wild and free. When I found you, your promise, I will walk in your word over me. In your love is a place like a wide open space. Call me out into all I can be. I found my life in the city. Of your promise, call me out into all I can.
Desperation, and all we know is doubt and fear. There is only one foundation, say, we believe in this broken generation. When all is dark, you help us see. There is only one salvation. We believe.
That's right.
we believe. We believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and that He's given us new life. Sing. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered hell. We believe in His resurrection, and that He's coming back again. So let our faith be more than anthems, more than the songs we sing. We believe, sing that out, sing.
Your tears will dry,
your heart will mend, your scars will heal, and you will dance again. You believe that? Come on, let's give him praise for it. So praise him. Tell your neighbors all about. Let the whole earth sing and shout. So our God is faithful. Praise him for his love and mercy. Praise him for his grace and favor. Praise him. Our God is faithful. Praise him. He is strong and mighty. Praise him. He is holy, holy. Praise him. He is always in control. His love has conquered all. His love has conquered all. Tears will dry, your heart will mend, your scars will heal, and you will dance again. And of his kingdom there will be no end, for Christ our King is coming back again.
In this place, we thank you for your faithfulness. You're worthy of our praise, God. We just say thank you, God, that you love us so much. Thank you, Lord, that you care for everything that concerns us today. Thank you that you turn our mourning into dancing again. You take sorrows and you turn them into joy. And God, all across this place, all those that are watching by stream, may they just sense your presence, God. We thank you that every giant is being defeated now in the name of Jesus. And we just thank you, God, for complete victory. We thank you for healings taking place, for blessings being manifested, God. God, we just thank you for your presence and your word tonight. We open our hearts ready to receive from you. God, it's no accident we're in this place. We know you have something in store for each and every one of us. You know us by name, intimately. You've fashioned us. You've wired us. And you desire to have an amazing relationship with us because you're madly in love with each of us. God, we just open our hearts tonight. We say thank you in advance for all that you're going to do. And if you agree, say amen and amen.
Today, we are so glad that you're here. And if you're watching online, thank you for joining. Thank you for being a part of the family. And what an amazing honor and privilege every single week we get as we gather together to lift up the name of Jesus. And make no mistake, that is what we are here to do this morning, to lift up the name of Jesus. And if you're new to Cottonwood Church, if this is your first time with us, we are so glad that you're here. And you need to know, we open every service with a time of what we call praise and worship, a time of singing, a time of reiterating and declaring aloud the truth of who Jesus is. And we got an amazing team that's going to lead us. There'll be words on the screen so that we can follow along. And we actually start every service with worship, with singing, because we believe it prepares our hearts for the preaching of the word. And we believe that that's when the Holy Spirit is actually most active, that it's the word that changes our lives. And that's why we sing, to prepare our hearts for the preaching and the teaching of God's word. But it struck me this morning, often we prepare our hearts for the preaching. We do that through singing, but how often do we prepare our hearts for singing and for praise and for worship? And I want to do something this morning. We don't normally do this in this particular section of the service, but I want to help us, and I want to do it with you. I want us to engage our hearts in order to prepare it for a time of praise and a time of worship. My Bible tells me that I'm more than a conqueror in every season of life through Christ. My Bible tells me I have joy in every season. I have joy in adversity, that I have all that I need in Christ Jesus, that he is my healer, my provider, my savior, my peace, my joy, all of these different things. And that's the reason we sing. So in an attempt to prepare your heart, in an attempt to prepare my heart, I wonder if maybe it'd be okay if you just lifted your hands. Now, I realize that some of you are new and you're like, why are my hands up right now? We do this as a church family. We do this as a church. We lift our hands. It's an expression. It's an outward expression of an inward posture of the heart, a heart that's surrendered before God. And what I'm going to ask you to do, the band's going to begin to play, but before they start singing, before I even stop talking, I want you to begin to lift up your own song, and to begin to prepare your hearts for the songs that we're going to sing this morning. Before you see a lyric on a screen, why don't your heart, through your words, begin to form lyric even now and make that as praise before God? Why don't you even begin to just lift your voice? God, we welcome you in this place. You are welcome here. You're first and you're foremost forever. Jesus, we're here to love on you in the best way that we know how. We trust that your word is true. We trust that your promises are yes and amen. We know that heaven and earth will pass away, but your word, it lasts forever. This morning, oh God, as we begin to lift our voice in adoration, as we begin to lift our voice in praise to you, we trust that you're enthroned. We trust that you take up residence in the praise and in the worship of your people. Hallelujah. We worship you in this place. Come on, why don't you begin to lift your voice now? The band's going to sing, but don't wait for them. Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you. Our Alpha and our Omega, our beginning and our end, the author and the finisher of all things. Jesus, you alone are our source. You are our salvation. You are our refuge. You are our strength. You are our fortress, oh God. We love you. The glory belongs to you. The glory belongs to you this morning. Hallelujah. We worship you. We worship you, Jesus.
A love this world could never stop. There is no one like our God. The broken and mercy breaking through this moment.
Faithful,
faithful is the one who saves. Worthy is your name. Oh God, the glory is yours. The kingdom is come and the battle is
desperation. When all we know is doubt and fear, there is only one foundation. We believe. We believe. In this broken generation, when all is dark, you help us see. There is only one salvation.
Before your throne, I stand in grace. enthroned upon the praises of his people. Come on, come on.
Christ our King is coming back again. Our tears will dry and our hearts will mend. Our scars will heal. We will dance again.
That's one of my favorite songs that we sing as a church family. Something tangible happens in the room. Faith lifts in the room as we begin to sing that song. And, you know, last night, I've been here for all of the services thus far, and last night, I felt like the Holy Spirit spoke to me in the midst of that song. I had always sung it and felt more because of the way it was written, that it was being sung over me. You know, there's the instruction to lift up your song, and that we should praise Him for His love and mercy, and praise Him for He's holy, holy, and He's always in control. And then we sing, and it's almost weird to sort of sing out loud, you know, your heart will mend, your scars will heal, and just lyrically the way it's written. And I felt like the Holy Spirit spoke to me last night. He reminded me of King David. King David in Psalm 42 and later on in Psalm 103 and a few other psalms, David would often speak to his own soul. Listen to these words. David said this. He said, "Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you in turmoil within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise Him. He's my salvation and my God." It's this idea that David is speaking to himself, that he's having this inner monologue. He's reminding his soul to sing because our God is good. It's as if, as we sing this song we've just sang, that we're singing prophetically over ourselves. We're singing, we're talking to our soul, reminding our soul, hey, your tears will dry. Your heart, it'll mend. Your scars will heal. You'll dance again because we serve the God that is in control. We serve the God that is full of grace and mercy. We serve the God that is holy, holy, the God that is so powerful and so mighty. And what an amazing honor and privilege every single week that we get to gather together as a church family and sing and declare the truth about who Jesus is. What an amazing privilege. And I wonder this morning, maybe just as a church family, if we could come before God united in prayer. If you wouldn't mind, maybe even just stretch your hands out in front of you a little bit like this. The reason we lift our hands, once again, we lift our hands as an outward expression. It resembles what's happening on the inside of our heart. It's a posture of surrender. God, we come to you as children this morning. Even our posture, our outward posture of hands extended, it's like the child running to its father. And God, this morning we come to you, we cry out to you. We need you. We don't want this to just be church service as usual where we check our box and go on throughout our week. God, we're here to meet with you. We need a touch of your presence. We need a touch of your spirit. We ask you that you would speak to us. We thank you that truly you are enthroned, that you take up residence in the praise of your people. So we acknowledge your presence here now. And we ask that as we get ready to hear your word, that you would speak to us by your word. We pray that as we've done our best to prepare our hearts to a time of singing and worship, God, that you would now, through your word, do something in our hearts. May the word of God go forth like seeds this morning. And may those seeds take root in the soil of our heart. May your word grow in us and produce fruit in us. We don't want to just be hearers, but we want to be doers of your word. Help us today as we examine your amazing love to grow in our understanding and our comprehension of it. And Jesus, today we say we love you, and we realize we can only say that because you first said it and demonstrated it to us. So we honor you. We exalt you in this place. We thank you that you meet with us. And it's in your precious name we pray. Amen. 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 Amen.
That's it. Come on, sing this out.
I was nowhere, you came to my rescue. From the grave I've been raised. When I
needed a Savior to save me. Jesus, you made a way. I was blind, but these eyes have been opened. Now I walk in the light. Every step on this road I will follow. Jesus, you made a way. So you are the way.
The broken, receive a Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet. My Savior on that cursed tree. His body bowed and drenched in tears. They lay him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still and all alone. Oh, praise the
trampled down.
Give you the praise and the honor and the worship that is due your name. God, we even declare tonight that whether or not you do anything else for us for the remainder of our physical life, you are still good and you are still worthy of our worship. You are still worthy of our praise. And tonight we declare that emphatically, that you are above all things, that you are before all things, that you, Jesus, you are first and you're foremost forever. We exalt you in this place. We don't take for granted the fact that we can gather together in an amazing facility like this as a family and lift our hands and lift our voices and say to you in the best way that we know how that we love you. But God, ultimately, we thank you that you first said that you loved us. We now live and we worship you from this place of response. So now we ask that by your Holy Spirit, you would prepare our hearts for your word tonight. We know that your word, it's living, it's breathing, it's active. And we ask that it would speak to us right where we are at. We ask that by your Holy Spirit, you would bring a revelation tonight. Open the eyes of our understanding that we would see what is the hope of your calling. What is the glorious inheritance we have as believers, that we would grab a hold of Jesus Christ. Glory. And we promise, God, to give you all the honor and all the glory forever. In Jesus' name, amen, 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 amen.
Good evening, everybody. Can you stand with me? I have good news for you. We came here to meet with a God that is actually more interested in knowing us than we are in knowing him. That's really good news. He actually is more interested in being close to you than you are in being close to him. But not only that, listen to what the prophet Isaiah says. In Isaiah chapter 40, he says, "Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary." God doesn't get tired. That's pretty cool. "And his understanding, no one can fathom." But listen to this. "He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak." God is in the business. Listen, he's in the business of giving out strength when we're feeling weak. He's in the business of restoring us when we need restoration. And he wants to know you more than you want to know him. So certainly, as we get ready to worship, we will feel his presence. We will be with him, and he will speak to us. Band, it's all yours.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Come on, let's all use our hands. Come on.
Your power unstoppable. Your tears will dry, your heart will mend, your scars will heal, and you will dance again.
Who you are, and I am loved by you.
Father, we just thank you tonight for being just a good, good Father to us. We're so grateful for your goodness, God. We're so grateful for you always taking care of us and being faithful. Even when we're not faithful to you, you rescuing us from the messes that we make of ourselves. God, we're grateful for that. Thank you, God. We open our hearts to you tonight. We look to you for instruction, for guidance, to get to know you more than anything else. Can I remind you of something tonight? We sing that song that God's a good, good Father, and he so is. I want to take that further and just say to you that God is actually more committed to your best interests than you are. He's more committed, it's true, he's more committed to your well-being than you are, which means that tonight we can trust him, that tonight we can open our hearts, we can let the walls down, we can let him truly speak to us, because we believe that he's more committed to us than we are to him, which means he would never do us wrong because he's a good, good Father. Let's give him a round of applause. God is good. It's good to be here tonight. Good to be with you.
Let's get ready to worship the Lord together. You know, most often when we want to think about Christmas, we begin to read through the Gospels to read the Christmas story. But recently, I came across a verse or reminded of a verse that really explains Christmas perfectly. It's in 2 Corinthians 8:9, where it says, talking about Jesus, he, being rich, became poor so that we who are poor might become rich. In the original language, the word poor actually means to be a beggar. So if you reread that, it says, he, being rich, became a beggar so that we who are beggars might become rich. That really speaks to what Jesus did for us, doesn't it? You know, the wealthiest man right now in the world, according to Forbes magazine, is worth $75 billion. Imagine the mansion he lives in and the cars that he drives, what he wears and what he eats. Could you imagine if that wealthy man went to a beggar on the side of the road one day and said, look, let me take your spot beginning today, and you can take my spot. That's exactly what Jesus did for us, but more in an infinitely greater level, didn't he? He who was rich became poor for us. No wonder the shepherd said, I bring you good news of great joy. So let's celebrate tonight as we think about Jesus, shall we? Let's sing about that wonderful night when the angels praised Jesus. Let's worship him together.
Joyful all ye nations. we sing praises to you, God. We sing praises of adoration to you, Lord. And I sing praises to your name. Praises to your name. The name that's so much higher than all names. And all honor to your name. Honor to your name. We thank you for your presence that is here. And we continue to sing of our love for you, God. Because all things have passed away. Your love has stayed the same. Your constant grace remains the cornerstone. Things that we thought were dead
Jesus, even as we sing that we love you. We recognize tonight the only reason we can sing that is because you chose to leave your glory behind, to leave the riches of heaven behind, and you limited yourself and was born as a baby, placed in a manger, and you grew up experiencing the heartache that we experience, being tempted in every way that we've been tempted, but yet without sin. And because of that, you can identify with our lives and with what we experienced. And ultimately, you went to the cross and you died and rose again. And because of that, Jesus, because of that amazing grace, we can say we love you because you first loved us. Thank you, Lord, for your beautiful presence here. Holy Spirit, we welcome you here and we say, have your way. We're ready to hear your word tonight because we know it's your word that changes lives. So we open our hearts wide to receive whatever it is you have. So change us tonight from the inside out. Lord, we love you. We praise you. And we lift up your name in this place. Amen and amen. Amen. It's good to be in God's house tonight, isn't it?